Hi guys, welcome to another video. In this video we'll be setting the gear linkages on my Golf 1. Please note, this may not be the correct way to do it, but this is the way that I do it, self-taught. So here we have the lever on the gearbox itself. This is where we select our gears. So as you can see, this is your neutral position. Your gear lever is now in the resting central position. So what I'm going to do, just for illustration, I'm going to go into the car, select first, third, sorry, reverse, 1, 3, 5, and then 2 and 4. So you can see the movement of this lever and where the gears actually lie. So let me go to that now. Okay guys, so that was reverse 1, 3, 5, 2 and 4, and I'll show you the significance of that in a bit. Okay guys, so as you can see, let's draw a quick diagram here. So this is how the gears actually work. Reverse 1, 3, 5, and on the left we've got 2 and 4. So if you manually want to select reverse on your vehicle, this is neutral. Pull it forward and to the right. That is now reverse. Sorry, there is reverse. Alright, so let's go underneath the car quickly. Okay, before we go underneath, it's got a lever here, gear lever. So this is what you see up on top. But underneath the car, this is actually what's there. This is then connected to a rod that comes to the front of the car. Let me go underneath and show you guys. Okay guys, so this is underneath the vehicle. That rod that I showed you is actually this here. Connects to this the gear lever. There's a bottom that connects to this shaft. And this shaft then goes all the way to the front of the vehicle. As you guys can see there. Okay, let me go to the front. Okay guys, this is towards the front. So there's a shaft going to the lever there at the back. It comes to the front. So firstly, we've got this bracket here with the bushing in there, red one. So you need to make sure that all your bushings are good. This bushing I replaced recently, but we've already got some play in it. If you guys can see it, but it does have play. The problem was my exhaust was right up against this. Obviously this bushing was heating up. And then that rod, as you can see, it's got a spline there. A 13mm spanner, nut and bolt. So you basically loosen this and you can move the spline, the shaft in and out, and you can actually turn it clockwise, anti-clockwise. That then goes into this little, I don't know what you call this, this here, this little box. And it's got they call it a lollipop, which is this thing here. So when that shaft moves front and back, it actually moves a lollipop, and the lollipop moves this shaft underneath here. It's a 13mm with it's actually got a keyway here. They only can fit in one direction, and it actually, when that spins, the shaft actually rotates. Let me go to the top and I'll show you guys this. Alright guys, so there's a little lollipop down there at the bottom, and as you can see, it's connected to a a shaft that comes up to this arm here. So when you move that the lever front and back, it pushes that shaft, pushes this lollipop, and then this lollipop moves up and down, and that turns the shaft. So let me see, I can show you. As you can see, the movement of that lollipop, and that turns the shaft. So this shaft in turn, as you guys can hopefully see here, this shaft comes all the way across and connects directly to the lever. And then we have another connection at the bottom that goes around the back. It's actually connected down here, the other part of the this little box that I showed you before. Sorry guys, I don't know the name. So in essence, what happens guys is when you pull your lever up and down, let's say 1 and 2 or 3 and 4, this part here actually moves left and right. And when you move it side to side, this actually moves up and down. So that's all controlled by the lollipop down there. So it's actually in the direct opposite of what you do in the car. Left and right means up and down here. Front and back means left and right here. So guys, the first thing you need to do is make sure that all your bushings is actually fine. Let me show you the bushing kit that I actually got. Sorry. Okay, so this is the bushing kit that I did get from Goldwagon. As you can see, all the bushes are there. So this is the red bushing that I showed you originally on the bracket, where that shaft moves funny back through. And these are all other linkages. So I've got a used set here that I did take off previously. This is that lollipop that I spoke about. As you can see, it's got a keyway in it, so the shaft fits in there. So when this moves front and back, it actually spins the shaft. I've got this bracket here. This is a bracket that I showed you guys. I think it's this way. This mounts onto your steering rack, and your lollipop actually fits underneath there like that. So as you guys can see, this has bushings in here. This is actually quite simple. It's these, let me make it clear, these see-through bushings here. Can focus. So see-through bushings there. So you just take a screwdriver, pop it out and put the new bushing in. There's two of the bushings, and then underneath here, this is where your shaft actually has got a fork that fits in there. Then you've got these little bushings here that fit there to prevent play on your shaft. And then this is the shaft that I showed you guys that I had standing out. Down here, let me get my torch. So you guys, everything painted black in this car. Yeah. So that there is the bracket that I showed you with those bushings. So you just need to make sure, wiggle this around, make sure there is no play on it. Then here, okay, let's start from the front. As you can see, you've got a bushing there, you've got a split pin. So if you wiggle this and you have play, excessive play, pull out a split pin, use a screwdriver, pop this out, pop it in your bushing. One bushing there, you've got a similar bushing down here. Those two bushings on the shaft I've explained. And then down here at the bottom, you've got a little short arm. It's got a notch in it. You can put a screwdriver open, pop the seal, a little lever out, and then pop this up. And it's got a little rubber bushing down there. You can get there. Yeah. So you can see this little tab down here. front you put your screwdriver, pop it out, this lifts up and you can put the bushing in there. So guys, the bushing is actually quite simple to do. This is more to explain the setting of the linkages, but firstly just make sure you have no unnecessary movement in your linkage system. So guys, as I said, the setting of this is you basically need a reference point, and my reference point is if you put this in your neutral position. Okay, that's your neutral position. That must actually be your neutral position on your lever. So your lever must actually be in the center. Okay, so the only adjustment that you do have on your vehicle, as I did show you, you need this needle to it. Look at that angle here. Okay. See, we can point to it. That's the shaft that comes from your gear lever, the one with the spline. So guys, by actually, that's the only adjustment you have. You can move it clockwise, counterclockwise, front and back. So what I suggest is put your lever in a neutral position and then adjust that. So you can move it clockwise, counterclockwise, left, up and down. That's the only adjustment that you should have. That's my experience and what I generally do. So get someone to hold your lever in a neutral position inside where you want it adjusted, and then you go to the bottom there and you adjust that. You just make sure it's in the right position. Well, the other thing you could do is put this, put this into reverse, so forward and right, and then go into your vehicle and put your gear lever into reverse, so it's down and left up, down and basically number one. So you've got, you know where your reverse should be in a vehicle, you know where your reverse should be here, and you just adjust that point down there with your spline back forward, clockwise, counterclockwise. So that's the only adjustment you should have. If your lever is, hold on a second. If your lever is too forward, the neutral is not in the center, your neutral is a bit up. So all you need to do is the spline, you need to loosen up the 13, and then you need to push the spline in. So this will actually pull the shaft down. If your lever is not centralized, if your lever is actually sitting there, you just rotate the shaft counterclockwise, it brings your lever neutral position. So that's it guys, you put your gear select only box in the neutral position, which it will go automatically in. You get someone to hold this here and you go underneath, or you loosen the shaft, you loosen the 13 there, you put the shaft in with everything loose, you want someone to hold this in the neutral position of where you want it to be, and then you tighten, get everything sorted on there, and then tighten it and check for your gears. Alternately, second way, as I showed you, you select reverse up front, then you put this in reverse and you connect your spline down there, play around your spline. So it's actually quite simple. Just by playing with the shaft back, forward, clockwise, anti-clockwise, you select your gears. But the main thing is to make sure your bushings are all right, because if you have excess play in your bushings, then your selection is not going to be right. When I took this car in for a branch the other day, when I came out, I was not getting first and second. So all I did was the shaft, I turned it clockwise a bit because my lever was too close to this arm that prevents you from going into reverse. All I did was turn it clockwise and now perfect, everything selects fine. So guys, I hope this helped you out somehow. Please guys, like, share, subscribe. Okay guys, so here we've got a steering rack. This is your steering rack, driver side, passenger side. So this here, as you guys can see, it's got a point there for seeing. Slides in at the top here. So it's got a bolt underneath, bolt here at the back. That's where your shaft, gear shaft, to fit through. And then if we turn this upside down, if you're looking from underneath here, this is the rear bush that I spoke about. Fits in there, 2/13. So change this bush is quite easy, as you can see. It's got a flat screw here with a nut in the back. It's two pieces. Open it up, split it apart, slide in your bush, put this top piece back on, and tighten it, and that's it. And speaking of the shaft, I took the shaft out as well, guys. So there's a shaft. There you guys can see the shaft actually fits in there. The bushings in there, and then you've got a special nut that fits in there. This blind is what I was speaking about. It is blind here, guys. So by moving this in and out or left and right, you adjust your the position of your gear lever. So this is only adjustment that you should be making. Hope this helped you guys. Thanks. Keep watching. Bye.